So you might have traveled to the northern part of Africa and probably visited the hard-to-reach oases or places where live the indigenous Berber people, also called the Amazigh, and you wonder where these people come from. Sure, their traditional culture and habitats have no doubt attracted many travelers to experience their warm hospitality, which they are normally known for. And today, I'm going to talk about them since they have an interesting history. There are many different groups of Amazigh that are either scattered across the ochre desert dotted with oases or live on mountain tops. For instance, in Morocco, you'll find some of the Amazigh living in the Dra Valley or Atlas Mountains, while in Algeria at the Oris Range live the Shawi people. And if you travel around the Mediterranean coast, there are the Kabyles. But in the Sahara Desert, you'll end up meeting the Tuareg, touted as the blue people who dress themselves in traditional blue clothes. In Tunisia, precisely in the picturesque Dakruna village, live descendants of the Moors who came from Andalusia in the 8th century. But there are also the Zenata Amazigh who live in fascinating troglodyte caves in Matmata. And if you travel to the Canary Islands, then you'll be surprised to meet descendants of the Amazigh known as Guanches, who are the original inhabitants of the islands. So let me talk about the word itself, Berber. Berber is derived from the word Barbary, which was the Maghreb coast in the 19th century. Now, Maghreb is the northwestern part of Africa, consisting of places like Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, Libya, Mauritania, and the Western Sahara. But the word can also be traced to the Greek word barbaroi, which means barbarian. Berbers were also called the Amazigh, which means free or noble people. Ancient historians call these people by different names. For instance, Numids by Strabo, Morais by Pliny, Getulians by Sallust, and Libyans by Herodotus. Interestingly, the Maghreb region was subject to several reigns, from Romans, Phoenicians to Carthaginians, Vandals, and Ottomans. That led to a culturally rich Amazigh population. Scholars such as St. Augustine, Procopius, and Ibn Khaldun claim that the Amazigh were descendants of the Canaanites chased from Palestine. Others also believe that they were descendants of the Thracians, Celts, and Gauls. Legend has it that they were survivors of the Atlantis before it sank into the sea. In short, the Amazigh could be from the Middle East, Canaan, Yemen, Ethiopia, Thrace, Asia, the islands of the Aegean Sea, Northern Europe, the Iberian Peninsula, or Italy. Back in the 7th century AD, some parts of the Amazigh countries were invaded by the Muslim Umayyad Arabs. Later, some Bedouin Arabs, Syriacs from the Near East, and some Jews and Muslims fleeing from the Spanish Catholic Reconquista arrived in the Maghreb region, which subsequently resulted in some genetic diversity among some North Africans. Interestingly, a study conducted in 2005 revealed a close mitochondrial link between Amazigh and the Sami of Scandinavia, putting forward that southwestern Europe and North Africa was the source of late glacial expansions of hunter-gatherers that repopulated Northern Europe after the last glacial maximum, and reveals a direct maternal link between those European hunter-gatherer populations and the Amazigh population. Another study conducted in 2012 about the genetics of the North African's human population was published in PLOS Genetics. The study was undertaken jointly by researchers in the Evolutionary Biology Institute and Stanford University, among other academic institutions. researchers analyzed around 800,000 genetic markers distributed throughout the entire genome in 125 North African individuals belonging to 7 representative populations in the whole region. And the information obtained was compared with the information from the neighboring populations. In-depth study of these markers shows that the ancestors of today's North Africans were a group of populations that already lived in the region around 13,000 years ago. Well, the Maghreb region has no doubt attracted many of the fascinating ancient civilizations, which have, of course, shaped the history and culture of the Amazigh. So more studies should be encouraged to get more insight about the origin of the Amazigh people. I hope you find this episode interesting. Thank you for listening, and I'll meet you on the next episode. Take care.